Hey y'all, Get Level here. I just got done creating this overlay in Canva. And I wanted to make like a vague tutorial where I was like, hey, here's kind of how to do it, but I'm gonna share the template for free so you don't need to do all of that. Just figure out how to customize it. After 1 hour and 30 minutes of customizing this thing and making it, I realized that the whole share template link feature is not free anymore. So it's a premium feature. I am pretty frustrated, of course, because I was really happy that you guys could just, you know, click on the link, change a little bit of text around and boom, have this overlay. And also know that you can do this in Canva. But now I'll just share them as image files. So you just still have access to the overlay, but it's gonna be way less customizable. Anyways, the following video is going to be a couple of steps on how I created it. So if you're completely lost, you've never used Canva to create anything, maybe that will give you some insight. I'm not a Canva pro by any means. So I think it's even better for you to watch this video because you can see how intuitive it is. It's not a step-by-step guide because I didn't have that in mind when I was recording it, but hopefully it's a good showcase on what is possible to create in Canva. Now, in case you end up hating what I make today, just know that this is not the only time I make tutorials on Canva or even set overlays for free. Oh yeah, and also I'm gonna be using, you know, the free version of Canva because I'm not paying for Canva. All right, so we have a 1080p. So we have a 1080p canvas now. And we're gonna start by setting the background to black. Once again, this is not gonna be a step-by-step tutorial, mostly like a guide on how to customize it if you actually end up using the template. And I'm gonna use a couple of rectangles to basically block out the scene. I'm gonna do like one of those intermission screens or gameplay scenes with a border because those seem to be very, very popular. So when I click on elements here, I can find shapes. I actually don't want a rounded rectangle. Let me control Z on all that. I want a normal rectangle. We're gonna do something with a sharp design. I'm just gonna drag the corner. And honestly, like one of the best things you can do is hold shift when you're dragging those corners to maintain the aspect ratio. So if we're doing something for our webcam or gameplay and we know it's 1080p, all we have to do is basically make it fill the screen. That way we know it's 1080p. Hold shift and then drag. That way we know, hey, this is 16:9 aspect ratio. Perfect. And release, we're just gonna place it. Nice, I'm gonna check the options. Is there duplicate? Boom, we're gonna duplicate that. We're gonna place it around here. Now I kind of want the same amount of space on the left here that I have on the right, or same space on the right that I have on the left. Just eyeball it. It's not a huge crime if you don't get it right. And this is where the chat is going to be. All right, we'll go back to those later on, but I wanna play with the background so we can have a feel of everything already. So on the left here, I might go to photos. Oh yeah, they have AI image generator. Wow. I'm gonna type bokeh, basically out of focus backgrounds. See if I can find anything interesting. You know what, not bad. I just want something to kind of populate the background, but we're gonna do the design. Okay, while we have it here, we can right click on it, go to layer and center back. I'm gonna go to edit up top here, then go to effects, go to duo tone, and we're gonna go to pop. And we're basically gonna pick something that might align with the colors we want. Peppermint, lavender. Yeah, we'll stick to lavender for now. All right, then up top, I want the transparency to be pretty low. Okay, now let's go back to elements. Let's find some squares or rectangles. I immediately want to pick the color of this. Is that the color? There we go. But yeah, I am definitely going to be lost at like a couple times. There's gradients already. I like this one. How do I edit the gradient? Right here, click on this one. I want it to be a little like that. This is pretty nice actually. Okay, cool. I want this to be long. I want this to rotate. Wait, let me hold shift. Oh, shift doesn't do anything. It just size it up. Control, no, alt. All right, there's no snapping on the... All right, let's go 35 degrees and we'll place it something like that. Make it big. If you watch my other tutorials, you know my motto. Graphic design is just placing a bunch of rectangles, especially when you're doing that kind of graphic design. Actually, I want the light part to be at the bottom. I'm actually flipping it, so we want 145 to get that same angle. Nice. This is actually annoying to have those things here, so we're gonna... Can I turn them off? Where's my layer list? Yeah, I couldn't figure out how to hide the layers, so I just made them transparent. I'm gonna be playing with this one, and I'm gonna control D to duplicate it. Nice, select the one that is underneath it. Move that, and then you can place it in a way that, you know, the gradient is a little different. You can see it's different. You can also play with the transparency, make that pop, edit the gradient, try out different setups. Wish there was a button to just switch the colors. All right, that's nice. Let's duplicate that one too. Place it on the other side. Show me the layers. What was it? Alt one. There you go. Make sure that's also behind. Okay, cool. Now select all three, holding shift, duplicate all three, move those around. Okay, unselect them and then just resize everything to be a little thinner. And also shorter. So we can really see that gradient. Let's hit that bottom transparent with another duplicate. I just want a super thin one over here. Bring it up, make it less transparent actually. Make it shorter, way shorter and thin. And under photos, let's find something free and abstract. We want to stay with the sharp theme. Like something like this would have been perfect, but we don't have that pro account. Let's just rotate this one 35 degrees and put it in place. We'll delete the previous one. All right, now Alt 1 to see the layers, bring it where it belongs. And then this one, delete. Okay, pressing B on my keyboard. We select that one. We go to edit. What was it? Hyperx filter, duotone, lavender. Not bad. And now we can lower the opacity. Okay. I'm going to go around and actually play with more opacities here. And honestly, in moments like this, when you already have, you know, something pretty decent, you can just export this image and then bring it back in again. Especially if your computer starts struggling a little bit. All right, let's Alt 1 for the layers. Absolutely using Canva like Photoshop right now. Let's bring our thingy things on top. Not transparent anymore, but the colors to black. And now I want to figure out the outlines. I believe border style is what it is. That's right, let's add a border. Border weight is that. Click on border color. I can't speak. Pick that gradient that you had. Click on it again. Try to go kind of for the opposite. For example, we have the lighter color at the bottom on the background. We want the lighter color to be up top for the gradient. It creates a pretty cool contrast. Let's do the same for this one. I probably should have selected both of them when I did that. Now let's go to edit. Oh, I can just edit the shape. That's it. Okay. Now I absolutely forgot if there was a drop shadow feature. So I'm going to go to elements. I'm going to go to shadow. I'm going to type shadow under graphics. Or maybe I should just search blurry rectangle. There you go. It's green, but that's not going to stop us. How do I stretch it?
For some reason, it would not let me stretch it. I could scale it proportionally, but not stretch.
I need you to stretch, buddy, not crop. How do you guys use this thing, man? That is beyond me. Okay, Alt 1, bring this down behind, of course. Cool, let's duplicate it, rotate it. This might not look as good as I... Okay, we get a little bit of pixelation, but it's not too bad. I'm gonna lower the transparency even more. And of course, I'm guessing there's no blending mode here. Let's bring that down. Oh. There we go. All right. So for the chat, we're not going to have something necessarily directly in place. So you could keep it like this, but maybe I do want a little bit of transparency. But if I lower transparency, is it going to do the same to the border? Yes, it is. All right, we're going to cheat it. I'm going to do this. I'm going to duplicate it. Make sure it's in the same position. Please tell me I can have a hollow one. Yes. And no color. Okay. And this one can be full color. Nice. No one the wiser. Now, this is the part where you start putting decoration. We're going to add some labels bars at the bottom, but I'm going to just decorate that border because right now, just single border, a little too easy, if you will. So under elements, let me type sci-fi. Oh, why am I struggling? I could have just... I could have just brought that. They already have sci-fi elements, man. No one told me. Anyways, we can crop this and use specific parts only. Press enter. Kind of weird it's not letting me pick a gradient for that. I'm gonna color pick this color to kind of match whatever I have going on here and just place it. You can duplicate it, rotate it, change the color, duplicate again. I'm gonna flip it this time. Color pick. Nice, and we're just gonna continue like using a bunch of those little things to decorate this whole thing. We're gonna do the labels bars, same technique. We're gonna have rectangles, we're gonna have a border, and then we'll just decorate that border. Boom, and there it is. In total, that took 1 hour and 26 minutes. Oh my. Now, as I said, I could probably optimize this. Well, you could probably optimize this by just taking all of the background elements, exporting them separately if you're making this for some reason. But I'm just going to leave everything and I'm going to share the template. So you can come here, change your name, just double click on it. Intermission, you don't want it to say that. The logos here at the bottom, for example, I have a heart for follows, a dollar sign for tips, and then a crown for like top tipper. This is mostly for people who are not affiliate yet. If you are affiliate, then in that case, you know, add whatever icons you want. You would want chairs, subs, and then tips. And of course, since we're using the free version of Canva, we're not gonna be able to export this with transparency. So what we're gonna do in OBS Studio is we're gonna use a color key to key out the black here. You can also set it to green or whatever color that is not currently present in here. I'm gonna set it to black and see how it goes.
And there it is. After an hour and a half working on this thing, I realized that template links are no longer free, practically ruining the whole premise of the video.
Template link is no longer... No, there's no way, there's no way. Template link is now a premium feature. Stop using Canva, man. Just stop using Canva. Why are you using Canva? Why are you using Canva at this point? Oh, that's crazy. And I'm just gonna download the image. I'm gonna download multiple where I'm gonna get rid of the icons if you want to replace them. I'll get rid of the text if you want to replace that. All right, when it's finally time for you to bring in those images into OBS Studio, we're gonna do what we said. We're gonna bring them as an image source. You'll find them where you downloaded them. And let's go with this one. And we're gonna add a filter to that. We'll add the filter, and the filter will be a color key. This one comes with OBS, so no plugins, nothing fancy. And a custom color, we're gonna select the color and it needs to be black. Click OK. And there it is. Now there might be a little bit of spillage here. You can adjust like the settings to make it better like that. And there you go. You can adjust the camera behind it and make it really fit. And it's that simple. So if you want to export something with transparent background, if it's going in OBS Studio, you can always use a color key. Alrighty, once again, link in the description just for the images since I can't share the template. And I will see you next time. Let me know in the comments if like you're still gonna use Canva or if I should even bother, you know? But in the meantime, you can follow me on Twitch and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.